My name is Frederick Demons. I'm a former I'm an alumni of Colaberry. Went through the school, I think, in 2018. I want to kind of get rid of all you all's fear as far as applying for jobs, maybe getting denied, maybe not knowing what you think you should know on the job. My first job out of Colaberry was a data engineer. I was a senior data warehouse developer slash data engineer. Once you get to the senior position, they pretty much tie you as a data engineer. So my job is SQL heavy. My job is ETL heavy. I touch a lot of packages. I create packages. I modify packages. And those were the jobs I was applying for, because at the time I went through the school, via the first two orientations we went to, this is what they told me you paid the most. So those are the jobs I'm applying for. But I want to make sure none of you all are becoming stagnant or slowing down because you don't think you know what you need to know on a job, okay? So I was someone who did the entire coursework, took great notes, and I thought I knew what I needed to know and still didn't. That stuff you're going to learn on the job, don't worry about that. I don't care how meticulous you are, you're still not going to know everything you need to know. Some of you all have even more fear because maybe you was turning in somebody else's homework, you was getting help from someone else, you weren't doing the assignment, so you have all these reservations. But I just need you to understand and keep in mind, there's a method to this madness, and it's done intentionally and on purpose. Like, no one is steering you in the wrong direction. Keep in mind, I know it's hard to believe because you're going to school for what, 6 months to a year? And coming out making close to six figures, if not more, it defies logic, because everything we've been taught about scholastic education is that you should be in a lot more debt and it should take you a lot longer to get a job paying that much. So it's counterintuitive to everything you've been taught up until this point. But there's thousands of people who've graduated Colaberry and been placed. So I need you all to trust the process. And that's what I did. Someone told me about this. A data architect told me her colleague went through it. She didn't even go through Colaberry. She said, you should check it out. And I just got registered and went full steam ahead. I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know what data analytics was. I have a sales background. So all of this was new to me, but I just took meticulous notes and went through the class following the process. And I just trusted the process, because when I was going through it and looking at the details of the instructors and all of the help they have afterwards, that's really what made me make sure I followed through. When Ali talked about the alumni group, where you can ask questions in case you're on the job and you're stuck, when they have like job help, when you can submit your projects and someone to work it for you and walk you through what they did, there's no other university probably in the world that's going to do that for you. You know what I'm saying? So the help you get after the job is the reason why I really followed through with Colaberry and just did everything they told me to do. Now, some of you all are having reservations because you're going to go through interviews and you're not going to know the answer to questions. That's normal, okay? I don't care what school you go to or what college you go to or what boot camp you go to. You're not going to know every question a manager is going to ask you. So you're going to, it's a numbers game. You have to go through the process. My particular manager that hired me for my first job didn't ask me a bunch of questions, because my tell me about yourself story pretty much answered all of the questions he had. Now, keep in mind, mine was different. So you all have projects and things you all could show during the interview. I just need you all to follow the process. Like, you got to understand, like, Harvard graduate created this. You know what I'm saying? So keep in mind that he's smarter than all of us. So he knows what to do to get you hired. So when I went through the interview, his first question was, tell me a little bit about yourself. And I went through it pretty much. If you all look up my interview, I'm Frederick Demons. I pretty much said the exact same thing. They asked me two or three technical questions after that about primary keys, precedence constraints, and something else. I don't remember what it was, but I went to, my job is in San Antonio, but at the time I was living in Dallas. So I went to a satellite location in Dallas and video conference, the manager and the lead. They could see me, but I couldn't see them. On my drive home, the recruiter called me and told me they made me an offer before I even got home. So this is maybe 10, 15 minutes. When I'm driving home from Irvine to Louisville, the recruiter called me. So do not think that you don't know enough and, you know, you're not going to be able to answer these questions. I need you all to follow the process, because even once you get on the job, you're going to know a lot more than you think you know. You may be overwhelmed because of the environment, but my first week, maybe two, my lead BSA said, man, we're so glad to have you because the last guy we hired couldn't even write a select statement. So it's weird how much this place teaches you, especially in contention point, how much money you all make. My first couple weeks, I remember going over code review with Debbie, who's on our team, and I did something, and she was like, show me how you do that. Now, mind you, I'm fresh out of Colaberry. I'm 2 weeks. She used to be a report developer, and now she's on the BI team, and our stuff is SQL and SSIS heavy. So she had me show her something. She's been in SQL for way longer than me. Keep in mind, I have a sales background. So I just want you all to trust the process. Don't think because maybe you skipped a couple homeworks to turn someone else in that you don't know enough, because the help that you all are going to get once you're on a job is better than anything else in the industry. You know what I'm saying? So I don't care whether or not you took good notes or didn't take good notes. Do the interviews, do the mock interviews, make sure you can answer some of these questions. You all have done the videos. Sooner or later, you're going to get an interview that coincides with the questions you know the answer to. All right? My first probably 3 or 4 interviews, I couldn't answer the questions. One was a reporting interview. I don't even know how they got me because I didn't apply for no reporting jobs. So I don't know how I popped up there. So he called me. I couldn't answer those. All right, next one. I remember interviewing for Whole Foods in Austin, and it was a Power BI team. This was before the internship. So I got a job before Power BI, and they was allowing interns to do that. They said, oh, don't worry about it if you don't use it. We're just pretty much writing select statements. But he asked me questions about, you know, who owns various aspects of the data flow, and I was like a deer stuck in headlights. You are going to get interviews where you're not going to know the answers to every question. That doesn't mean anything. All you're doing is worrying about the interview where you do know the answers and they do want to hire you. But do not think that they're going to hire you just because of your technical prowess. I have 2 friends who've recently gotten jobs, 6-figure jobs straight out of Colaberry, Power BI developers. Some of them were hired because of their people skills. One manager actually told a guy, say, hey, look, I see your project. I see your resume. I know you can do the job. Just talk to me. I just want to get an idea of who you are as a person. And he really hired the guy because he had retail. We was in the same store. He had retail sales experience. So his ability to communicate and kind of relate to people really gave him a leg up, because once we're in IT, there's a lot of introverted individuals there. Some things get lost in translation because a lot of people in our field are foreign, which is great. But keep in mind, I just need you all to understand that you have no idea why they're going to hire you. So don't think because I know or don't know what Colaberry is teaching me, that's my only leg up in the game. So people hire for a vast variety of reasons, and it's not for you to determine the how. You just got to follow the process. When I went through it, I knew that the people who got hired before me wasn't any smarter than me. You know what I'm saying? So I was just going through the numbers. You just have to go through the nose until you get that one yes. And if that one yes is paying you $50, $55, $60 an hour, the nose doesn't even matter. You don't even remember half of the nose once you get that yes. I just need you all to follow the process. Do the mock interviews. Make sure you let your manager, your mentors know when you have an interview, so they can maybe schedule some time to do a mock interview with you, given the details of what the job requirements tell you that they are looking for. They're going to know more about it than you do, even if it's not there too. Like my friends who were recently hired were hired as Power BI. I pretty much do ETL and SQL all day, but I knew what they would be looking for because I'm in the industry. So I talk to BSAs. I deal with people. I have Power BI people sending me emails saying, hey, I need you to input this data into this table, or I need to see these columns and things like that. So once you're in the industry, you have a broad base and an idea of who needs what. But I need you all to follow the process. Don't question it. You all don't question these thousands of dollars of debt you're in when you get these degrees and they send you out there to go figure it out. Don't question Colaberry. Just the easiest way to do it is just follow the process and go ahead and go through the interviews. Can you question it? Absolutely. But it's not in your best favor. There's no point of causing undue stress. if they've placed thousands of people before you, you telling them to do it this way or why you, none of that matters. If these thousands of people who got jobs before you can do it, so can you. Do your interviews, have faith, follow the process. You're going to get an interview and a manager who's going to choose you for who knows what reason. Maybe it's your technical prowess. Maybe it's not. We have no idea. Sometimes it may just be the way you can communicate what you've done and the way you articulate your words. There's a variety of reasons why managers hire individuals. My two friends who just got hired, it wasn't because of their technical prowess. I know Chris personally. He's a great friend of mine. Chris told Cam about the program when he was going through it, and Cam read my success story, and I video called Cam and said, hey, do it. This is how you do it. I told him exactly what I did to go through the school to make it the easiest way possible, and my call closed Cam because it sounds, even if you read the success story, it sounds too good to be true. My call did it, and they both got six-figure jobs, and it wasn't because of their technical prowess. Their jobs loved them. Cam called me probably once a week, just telling me about the job. He just turned in a BI dashboard, who the owner loves. He works for a law firm. The owner loved his dashboard. So the meticulousness they have with the school, the way, you know, Ali is telling you, hey, that's not good enough. You need to do this. You need to change this. There's a reason for this. They're not trying to be hard on you, but keep in mind, I'm going to tell you this much. The mortgage project I did at Colaberry is more involved than anything I've ever done on a job. Yes.
And I've told you guys that the mortgage project is harder than what you will be doing actually in the field. Like what you do in the field is not nothing compared to the mortgage project, but we do the mortgage project like that. So that way you can be self-sufficient and know how to troubleshoot and how to think on your own, because all of that, those three things, you're going to have to know how to do in the field.
Yeah. I have to, most of my job is modifying store procedures. So it is existing store procedure. This column is, we can't source this table anymore because they're getting rid of this table. So now I got to source this column somewhere else. I got to make this modification. Even when I do have to create brand new store procedures, there's so much like existing store procedures. Exactly. Some of the time, I'm copying it.
Copy and paste.
If you knew how much I copied and pasted on my job, you would have no idea. You'd be like, yeah, there's no way you're a data engineer.
I was the same way.
My job is copy and paste. All I do is format my query. So you know Alfred did this because it's formatted a certain way, which Colaberry told me, because a lot of times people don't format it any one specific way. So I formatted and it looked like I didn't really did it, but I didn't copy 90% of this query. I just needed to modify that and change that and change that. And then, yeah. So don't overthink it. Take it seriously, because these companies are not paying you a lot of money to go mess up their data or make mistakes. But the support you have in Colaberry and the support you have after Colaberry is unprecedented. That support is the reason why you need to move full steam ahead. Don't worry about the hiring managers. You're going to have interviews where you're not going to get the job. You're not going to know the question. Go through the numbers. You got to treat it like a sales. You got to go through the no's to get to the yeses. The minute they tell you yes, and you're getting that $50, $60 an hour, you're not going to care who told you no. My first job, I drove straight to my mom's and said, I got an offer. She was on the phone with my brother. He said he got a job. How much he making? I said $50 an hour. My brother hung up the phone. She had to call him back. She was like, he lying. There's no way he went to school for a year and got a job making $50 an hour. Okay. It happened. It happened. Trust the process. I really just wanted to let you know that there's nothing to fear, because you all have the support and you all do not know why your hiring manager is going to hire you. Do not worry about that. I got hired and they said the guy before me could not write a select statement. My manager said, look, do you know joins? That's all I need.
I told you guys, joins are important. I told you that, because you'll never get everything you need from one table. Joins are freaking important.
Look, there's nothing to fear. I have a high school diploma. I don't have any college degrees. I got my Microsoft certification way back when because I didn't have none of these tools that you all give you. They give you way more tools than I have. So they're placing people at a faster rate and people are making more money out of the gate. You know what I'm saying? So it's vastly different. But I just want you all to understand that there's nothing to fear so you all can move forward amicably, move forward with haste, and allow your mentor to help you. Because at the end of the day, they have a job and you don't. So even if they don't know as much as you want them to know, they know more than you. They know enough to get hired. So you have to go through the process. Go through the mock interviews, call those numbers, listen to those calls, the ones you don't know, look up the answer, follow the mentor, but make sure that you're doing your part as a mentor. If I want you to have the job more than you, you fail. You have to want it more than I do. I'm gonna help you get there, but you have to want it more.